another level.
Keep on, gotta keep on pressing on.
Isn't that amazing? A new year, a new decade. We talked about that last week. We are stepping boldly forward into this new year, into this new decade. And as I said last week, this is our 96th year. First Unity was founded in 1924. In just a couple of years, we're going to be celebrating our centennial. So just think how many levels that First Unity community has gone up. And here we are, and Wanda says we're coming to another level. Isn't that amazing? Yes, it is. So welcome to First Unity. We're going to stand up, and we are going to say our great invocation, because although we acknowledge and affirm that we are at another level, we also honor our history with Myrtle and Charles Fillmore. We are now in the presence of pure being and immersed in the Holy Spirit of life, love, and wisdom. We acknowledge thy presence and thy power, O blessed Spirit. In thy divine wisdom, now erase our mortal limitations, and from thy pure substance of love, bring into manifestation our world according to thy perfect law. And we know and affirm that we totally are bringing into manifestation what it is in our heart center, what we desire from that place of pure potentiality of the one presence and the one power. There are no limits. Infinite possibilities, infinite opportunities. And if you are here for the first time, I'd love for you to remain standing so our ushers can bring you a Get Acquainted card. And welcome to First Unity. Welcome. And welcome to everyone online from all over the world. I understand we have people from all over the world tuning in to us online every Sunday. What an amazing gift that is. And also know that from this community, we have people from our First Unity community that are in Australia right now helping, and we have people heading over to Puerto Rico to help. So we are, 96 was a number to take care of home and family, but also to nurture the people of the world. And here at First Unity, I can boldly state that we are doing that. And I am so grateful to be part of this community. And now I want to introduce you to someone who's been in our choir for a while. And if you made a New Year's resolution to get moving, to lose some weight, get in shape, man, you're going to love William Sanchez.
Soldado.
that didn't raise the energy for you, I don't know what can. So, First Unity will also help you get in shape this year. We're going to the next level in every single way. As artists, healers, seekers, activists, and as getting in shape people. Yes. So online, you know, you can tune in to the Zumba class every Wednesday evening after meditation. So you're going to come in here and be all calm and quiet. Get some meditation going. Then you're going to go in Longitude Hall and get some Zumba going before you go home. Yes. And then come in Monday nights and get a beautiful yoga as a quiet meditation with Reverend Dr. Aileen Curtin. So you can get your yoga, you can get your Zumba. Wow, what an amazing community we have. We come together on Sundays for our celebration service. We love that all of you come here and we get together and bring up all this energy into that vortex. It's so amazing. Then on Wednesdays is our quiet reflection day of meditation. I have meditation at noon out in the D'Alessandro Chapel on Wednesdays. At 6 o'clock, we come in here with our Reiki healers, and we have a beautiful guide of meditation with some kind of sound healing, whether it's Reverend Serena on the crystal bowls, or Rick on the angel harp, or Jim Kuhn on his fancy electronic guitar, or it's Joel and Don on drums and gongs. Some kind of sacred sound healing that is a treat. You need to come 6 o'clock on Wednesdays. Then on Sunday morning, we have a meditation in the D'Alessandro Chapel at 11 o'clock. That falls right in between both services. So whether you come early or you come later, you can come for that meditation. Our youth education, they're right upstairs right now. The teenagers are over in the other building. The nursery's open right down the hall. So if you have young ones and you're watching at home because you have young ones, know that we have a place for them. Right here at First Unity, we have a dedicated team in our youth ministry. And Jamie is also looking for some input from the congregation. On the 18th of January, you'll see in your program, he's having a meeting of all like-minded people who would like to help give something to the youth ministry. So if you have a song or a dance or storytelling, art, that you want to share with the youth ministry, come to that meeting. He's not asking you to make an every week commitment, but just an every once in a while thing. I'm going to go and be sharing Native American stories with them later on this month, and I'm so excited. I can't wait. So I would also at this time like to welcome all of our chaplains, our Science of Mind practitioners, our licensed Unity teachers, our ministers in training with the ILLI Institute, and ministers of any faith, if you all would please stand. See what a rich and vibrant community we are. And these people are all brought into service for you. So never feel bashful about tapping them on the shoulder, saying, I'd like to have you do something for me or with me. That's what they live for. They love that stuff. Yeah. So today our pet ministry is here. CJ Paws is here with kittens right out front. So take a chance to see the kittens. You know, we've adopted some 342, I believe is the exact number, of animals we have adopted through our pet ministry. So take a look at the kittens. And then today, immediately following the service, there's an artist reception in the I Am Center with Angala Grace. You may have caught a glimpse of some of her artwork as you came down the hall. But she's going to be in there to chat and talk with everybody about her art. And now, I'm so excited to bring up here for you, for special sharing, Reverend Maria Flournoy.
Wow. I had a vision last year that we would all be dancing Zumba in the sanctuary for 2020. And I thought I was just dreaming, but you know, we are so blessed. It's January. We're here at First Unity. We all embrace and embody this loving energy. And in January, it seems like we're all busy, active, planning what we're going to do for the year, where we're going to travel, which exercise class we're going to take. Hopefully it's Zumba. And we're all planning that. But I want you to take a moment now and hear what I have to say. All of that stuff out there that we love, the travel, the exercising, all of that starts with our realization of who we are. So when you take a moment for yourself, just a moment, and ask, what is being revealed to me this year? How am I going to show up? What am I going to realize for myself and my loved ones this year? So last year, I asked that question, what am I going to realize? And what came to me was, I want to come from more intuition and insight within my being. And actually, I realized that more and more. I got to the place where I call it my GPS system, my guided personal connection to source. That's my GPS system. And it's been working wonderful for me. So this year I said, well, what do I want to realize for myself and everybody I love, my community, my family? And I thought about it and I said, let me take some time because this is very important. But you know, the universe does not operate on a linear level. No. So this morning, when I opened up my daily word, the word for today is inner peace. And my heart just radiated and just felt this intense love. I had an aha moment. And I said, that's what I'm going to realize for myself and my loved ones this year. So I'm not going to read from you the daily word, but I will tell you that my experience of that inner peace is that knowingness, that connectiveness to source, to who you are, to how you realize yourself, to how you show up. So it's one of the same. When you're at inner peace, you are realizing yourself. And we're all here to support each other in being in that inner peace. But they tell a story, they tell a story of the Bible story of Jesus and the storm and how he had awoken up and he rebuked the wind and he said to the sea, peace, be still. And everything got still. And I liken that to our minds, that monkey mind, that static, that village out there that's in here sometimes. Yeah, we all have one. It's not just one voice. It's a village. I'm Italian, so we have a big village. It's big, big. And I liken it to when I've spent years meditating. I teach meditation. We all meditate. But when I finally got it, really got it, that all meditation is stilling the mind. So now, when I say, peace be still, it's quiet. Try it. Peace be still. It's quiet. That's how powerful we are as beings. So this year, I encourage all of us, because you're already in my realization, and I'm in yours, I hope, and we did Zumba this morning. This year, I encourage you all to use your GPS system, your guided personal connection to source, and I encourage you to flip that channel to the PBS station. Does anybody know what the PBS station is? Peace be still. And as we move through our year and start realizing this wonderful, energetic being that we are, then all that fancy stuff or whatever it is that we want. Some of us might want a puppy, travel, new home. It doesn't even matter. It's already here. And I invite you all to consider Tuesday night, which is a class, the energy of it all, because thank you. Because that's when we get to explore that beautiful, awesome, ridiculously amazing, thanks to my husband, because I couldn't change that word, being who we are. We get to step into that holy ground and realize the truth for ourselves and each other, because we are one energy. And that is what I wanted to share today for all of you, and thank you.
We got some good advice coming at you right now, so listen up, listen up.
It's a brand new day.
He's the God of inspiration, the God of all creation. He's the one who'll see you through. Yeah, he's the Alpha and Omega, Redeemer and Creator. Here's what you've got to do. Yeah,
forget all your problems, forget all your worries.
Yeah.
God will make a way.
You know he's gonna make a way.
Forget all your problems, forget all your worries. It's a brand new day.
He's the God that keeps forgiving. He's the God that keeps revealing his promises to you. He's the God of every season, the God for every reason. Here's what you've got to do. Don't forget to
forget all your problems, forget all your worries.
Come on,
God will make a way.
Whoa,
forget all your problems, forget all your worries. It's a brand new day.
Yeah,
forget all your problems, forget all your worries.
You know,
God will make a way.
You know he's gonna.
It's a brand new day.
Everybody,
forget all your problems, forget all your worries. God will make a way.
You know him well.
Forget all your problems, forget all your worries. It's a brand new day.
Come on now, everybody.
Forget all your problems, forget all your worries. God will make a way.
In the presence of infinite divine spirit, as we do indeed forget our worries and let them go, send them off, set them free, let us now go to our sacred space, that space that we know, that we've been to, that we relax into. Take a deep breath in and breathe in that light, the love, the expression of who you are, and release any concerns. This is your moment right now. Your moment to realize the truth of your being. And in this moment, silently allow for Spirit to fill your being with the love and the light, the peace and the harmony, the joy and the well-being that is already there. And we ask silently, what is it that is to be revealed to me? How am I going to show up? Allow for those signs and wonders to appear easily into my world as I accept this wonderful, beautiful being that I am, radiating gratitude through every cell of my body and into this room. I fill that space with the light and love of who I am. I speak in truth. I feel the energy of my being. The frequency of love and harmony is here now. It's already here. I am realizing it. Ah, breathe it in. And just release any other concerns. This is our moment now. This is our time to be in the present moment with thyself. To thyself be true. The truth shall set me free. Let it go. And today, for this day, this moment, this year, I proclaim a joyful experience and expression for myself, for my loved ones. I allow that energy to flow through me. I fill my space with this love and light, and it radiates out to the planet, out to the universe. Breathe that in and allow your light to shine. And we together know in gratitude, thank you, Spirit, thank you. Thank you. And so it is. Amen.
Ooh. Tell somebody. My great-grandparents had the roaring 20s. Well, this is 2020. These are the soaring 20s. That's what we decided to call. I think April brought that. The soaring. Another level. Things are going to get better.
Better.
Come on, put your hands together. From this point on, it's only getting better. Here we go. People come.
People come.
People go.
People go.
Your life has been.
Your life has been.
Control.
Out of control.
You're confused. But don't worry.
Don't worry yourself. It will get better.
Ah.
Better. It will get better. Better. It will get better.
Why?
God is in control.
I want you to find the praise.
Find the praise.
Within your heart.
Within your heart.
Hold it close.
Hold it close.
Don't ever depart.
Don't ever depart.
Cause it gets cold in the night.
It gets cold in the night.
But you gonna be alright.
But you'll be alright. It will get better. Better. It will get better.
Yeah.
Better. It will get better.
Cause God is in control. Listen.
gonna get better with my family. It's gonna get better with me and my children. It's gonna get better. It's gonna get better. Tell him,
it will get better. It will get better.
Can you hear me now? Thank you. Come back out here. Come on, y'all. Come on. Yes, I said y'all. First of all, it couldn't get any better. Excuse me. Woo-hoo! Than Wanda in her green elf shoes.
They are better.
Let's sing a little bit more of that.
All right.
Get on your feet. Listen. If this is the first time that you've visited First Unity, or maybe it's the first time that you decided to come back in a long time, welcome. First of all, let me just say, where else in this city, or almost anywhere, that you could go and see this talent than First Unity? So it's no accident that you, if you're here for the first time, that you follow the divine, and you're here for this very reason. Because God is still in control. That's what we're here to share with you. The love of God, and the message that God is still in control. Welcome, welcome. I've been gone for a couple of weeks. Thank you very much. And you know what? And I always pulls up my heartstrings because people send me texts and messages and things. And I was out of town working, as you know. Then I was actually home in the bed sick last week. It was a booger. It was a real booger. But I had felt it coming on literally before I even left. And it went here, and then it went here, and I said, go there. So I rebuked it and got it out of there. But it's a new year. It's a new year and a new dollar. Oh, no, that's another song. But Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Oh, my goodness, the first of the year. How many people here made New Year's resolutions? Oh, my God. You know, if we believed in hell, some liars might be going. No, I'm saying that in jest. But New Year's resolutions. I can't believe only four people said they made a New Year's resolution. I'm sorry the rest of you are so friggin' perfect. But let's talk about the truth. I'm sure there's some people in here who have started the paleo diet. I'm doing the paleo diet. Oh, I'm not doing sugar. Listen, I rolled my eyes so hard I almost hit my butt. Oh, and this one. Oh, I'm not doing flour. I was a vegetarian, and I always make jokes about this in the office. I was a vegetarian for 20 years. At one point or another, I didn't eat flour, didn't eat sugar, didn't eat rice, didn't eat bread, almost didn't eat anything. But I just never lost the fluff. Y'all know I'm talking about fluff. So I just got smart with my fluff, and I went and got a spray tan. Because I figured that my fluff looked better brown. So I just had fluffy brown fluff. But no, then one time I gave up caffeine. Has anybody in here ever given up caffeine? Now, those people were more honest than the ones I asked about earlier. Listen, I have to say something. I'm going to drink some truth serum. I'm going to admit this honestly and open in this forum. Oh, it got dead silent. Because, see, you're ready to judge somebody. I was drinking 12 cups of coffee a day. See, I told you, judgment, judgment, judgment. So I had decided to stop drinking coffee. I'd make you do a little weak knee shout. Do you know what happens to you when you stop drinking cold turkey, stop drinking 12 cups of coffee? Well, the devil just comes up the back of your head here. And it's like a vice grip. And my employee said, oh, please, Richard, drink some coffee. Drink some tea, just put it on your lips, just wet your lips with it, because you're mean. You're mean without that caffeine. So I decided to start drinking caffeine. No, actually, I don't. I don't drink caffeine, very, 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 very little of it. But also, too, before I forget, let's think. I was homesick last week, and I was with you, though. When I'm not here, I usually watch online. And some of you, I don't know your names, but I pray for you because I see the vision of your face. And I pray for you, know that you're always on my mind. But last week, did Wanda Nero Butler not hit a home run? And sister, don't judge. But the people who didn't applaud, they're so weak because they're not eating sugar and flour. They can't hardly get their hand up. So please forgive them. New Year's resolutions. People usually do it cold turkey. I belong to the gym, had belonged to the gym since Jesus hung on the cross. And let me just back up here so you all can see. Last year I got my mind right and I decided, well, I'm going to get my diet right and my exercise right. I went, let me just Let me just fluff here for a minute. Not here, I'll just fluff here. I went from a 36 waist for my age, that's not bad. Thank you. And I know you front row, you couldn't hardly see over my roll. But these are actually a 32, and I could probably get my lunch done in here. Because I set my mind right. And I know that I couldn't jump into it cold turkey, but I eased into it and changed it all. So I pulled up the most 10 common things that people give up for their New Year's resolution. Number one was weight loss. Oh, Lord, it just went quiet in the church. Weight loss. And you know what? There's probably not even a thin person who at one time or another hasn't battled that within their mind, dealing with weight loss. And improving your finances. I'm going to leave that alone because y'all might leave. Exercise. And again, since I, for many years, have been a little bit of a gym rat, I know those people that join the gym in January are gone by March. So I've sometimes thought, well, maybe I will stop going in January and just go back in March because all those people will be gone and I can jump right on the equipment. But exercise, and you've got to get your mind right. And honestly, statistically, a good trainer will tell you it takes you 3 months to reprogram your mind to start liking exercise. And you usually give up in about 3 weeks. And then those people who want to get a new job, they set their New Year's resolution on getting a new job. Eating healthier. Stop smoking. I know none of y'all in here smoke. And I have to say, I pride myself on saying I've never even tried smoking. But I didn't say I didn't participate in some of the other stuff in college. Stop your judgment. It's a new year. And then improving your relationship. You know what, in 2019, Lord, I'm just telling my age, aren't I? 2019, I had all kinds of relationships get wobbly. I did say my New Year's resolution was to improve all relationships. Again, the church goes quiet. That includes, you know, your wife, your husband, your children, your work relationships, because you know you have a wife husband or a work husband and a work wife. But work on improving them. Stop procrastination. First service, there was a typo there, and it said stop procreating. And I let them know I had solved that one. I had done that one. I had mastered it. But stop procrastinating. I have to say, I'm a Gemini, as you couldn't tell. Those who know those signs. And my procrastination is my other personality. Did something go on over here? Behave. But procrastination, it's that I'm Gemini. My other personality is the procrastination personality. I have the overachiever who will burn the nap off this carpet going out the door. But then I also have the opposite side of that coin is the procrastinator in me. Well, I can do that tomorrow. Or I can do that later because I'm busy reading a book because I love to read a book. Then set aside more time for yourself. Why'd the church go quiet on that one? If you take more time to focus on yourself, you can focus on others even better. And then the last one we added the first service is don't judge, because y'all have done a bunch of judgment up in here. But these are beautiful New Year's resolutions. And they're really the core of all of them is getting your mind right. Put your hand on your head. Get your mind right. Meditate on getting your mind right. Be open for the universe to help you get your mind right. And that's not necessarily a flaw. That's just something we always have to reprogram. Redo. Y'all can take your hands off your foreheads now. Lord, I thought I was at a healing service. Let me tell you a story. A story that I love about getting your mind right. And it's a biblical story. And I'll paraphrase it. There was a lady who had an issue of blood, and she bled for like 12 years. And I'll paint you a picture. Sicily, 1942. Oh, no, that's the Golden Girls. She was looking out her window out into the garden. And the story was that Jesus was supposed to come through the garden. And she had bled for 12 years. And she had said to herself, if I could just touch the hem of his garment, I would be healed. And supposedly Jesus came through the garden, and she went out into the garden, and I visualize her being down below everyone because she's not feeling worthy in her mind. Down below, as the people are walking, she's almost crawling till she comes to the hem of Jesus. And she touched the hem of his garment. And the Spirit of God quakened and awakened what had happened in Jesus. And Jesus said, who touched me? And the woman said, I have touched you. And he said, you are healed. You are healed in your mind. He didn't have to turn around and lay his hands on her. She already affirmed, if I would just touch the hem of his garment, I would be healed. What a beautiful story. There's another one that I love. And I pull out my old PTL Parallel Bible. It's been loved. It's been worn. I've taught out of this so much. And it was a gift from my little friend Tammy Faye. And her signature's in the front of it. But I love in John, I'm going to read a little story to you. Because it's metaphysically what goes on. In John, the 5th chapter, it said, after Jesus returned from Jerusalem for one of the Jewish religious holidays inside the city near the Sheep Gate, with 5 covered platforms or porches surrounding it. Crowds of sick folk, it actually says folk. Crowds of sick folk, lame, blind, with paralyzed limbs, laid on the platforms, waiting for a certain movement of water. For the angel of the Lord came from time to time and disturbed the water. And the first person that stepped into it was healed. One of the men laying there had been sick for 38 years. When Jesus saw him, he knew how long he had been ill, and he asked, would you like to be well? And look where the man's mindset was. I can't, the sick man said, for I have no one to help me into the pool of movement water. While I am trying to get there, someone else always gets ahead of me. Jesus told him, stand up, roll up your sleeping mat, and go home. How often in life have you been sitting here at the platform? Maybe 38 years. And we keep blaming why we've not reached our destiny, why we've not reached our goals, why we've not reached our journey's end, why we haven't succeeded. It's because we blamed it on someone else stepping in front of us, getting in the water. And I'm going to paraphrase here. Jesus probably said, brother, get your butt up and go home. Because the mat is that spot of comfort that you've grown accustomed to. Whew. That mat is that area that you put your fluff on and have sat and been content with not getting in the water because you waited for someone else to put you in the water. Jesus said, you don't need the water. Pick up your mat and go home. Okay, for those who don't prescribe to Jesus, the universe said, pick up and move on. Stop letting someone else define you. So I ask you, are you picking up your mat and going home in 2020? Or are you going to stand on or sit or lay on that little porch and feel sorry for yourself because someone always beats you to the draw, always beats you to the end, always beats you to the promotion? Well, I'm going to say to you, pick up your mat, or even better than that, leave the mat alone and get home. Get home. Because you're missing your destiny. You're missing your journey. You're missing what the universe has in store for you by letting someone else or something get in your way. Don't let a past relationship define where you're going to be. Don't let 2019 define where you're going to be in 2020. That should make some of you happy. Don't let your ex-husband define what your new relationship is going to be that God's going to bring you. Don't let your mama's action as a child define how you're going to react to her as an adult. Pick up your mat and go home. I said, pick up your mat and go home. Be responsible for your destiny. Be responsible for your future. Be responsible for what God has in store for you today. Be responsible in claiming your destiny. And I liked yesterday, I was in a counseling session with someone and I asked her if I could paraphrase her and use her words. She said, I can't eat the fruit if I never plant the seed. But also, I can't eat the fruit if I'm not patient for the tree to grow. Well, your tree has been growing. I'm saying to you now, your tree has been growing. Get ready to eat the fruit. I will say, get ready to eat the fruit. So in 2020, don't be walking in the sorriness of 2019, 2018, 2017. Step up to the plate and get ready to hit that ball into the outfield. Be ready. Because if you don't, somebody else will. They're going to continue to claim your journey. They're going to continue to claim your victory. So I will say this in closing. Whew. Can you tell I've been away for a little while? Be ready for what the universe has in store. You've sat on the bank long enough. You've sat here being sorry for yourself long enough. Be ready to pick your mat up and run into the destiny of your future. Thank you for being here.
We've all got our mats rolled up. We're ready to go. Yeah. You know, here at First Unity, we are such an amazing community. And this holiday season, we ask you to step up to the plate. We had an angel tree, and we had an elder's tree. We ask you to step up to the plate. And then we did. As a community, we came together, and we furnished such wonderful gifts for the children and the elderly in our community. Operation PAR and Healthy Start both sent us beautiful letters of gratitude and thank you for all that our community did stepping up to the plate. So now I want to thank you for stepping up to the plate, because it took each and every one of us. What a wonderful thing we did, helping those children have a Christmas and those elderly people that are shut in at home know they were cared for, and they received those presents. And then I also want to ask Carol D'Alessandro to come up and tell about another opportunity we gave you to step up to the plate. Wanda, come on down. I feel like Bob Barker. Now see, some of you told you age, because he hasn't done that in a long time. Come on down.
You know, so many people ask the question, what does love look like? All you have to do is look at this lady.
Yes.
I've learned in my own life that the way one does small things is the way they do everything. And when you look at Wanda Woman here, she's the real deal. We just really, as two friends, as the Board of Trustees, we want to thank each and every one of you for showing the generosity of what we can do as a team. couple months ago, we threw out the idea that this wonderful, wonderful woman who has given so much to the community, she needed a car. And I'll tell you the reason she needs a car is because over a year ago, she made a commitment to our church, which was to bring her talent and her love here to make us be better and better and better, like she sang this morning. Wanda lives part of the time in Atlanta, has a family there, has another church there. She made a commitment to us that she would come at least 50% of her time to First Unity. We're not able to pay her much. We'll get into that at another meeting, trust me on that one. But we're not. But the way she has paid us back has been phenomenal. She flies, I want you to understand that she flies home every 2 weeks on her own dime to spend time with her family. And a perfect example of how she has dedicated her life to us and her time and her energy and her love was this past Christmas. We knew that Reverend Temple was going to be in New York City giving the wonderful peace message. And Wanda was going to be here. And I asked Wanda about a week before Christmas, I said, Wanda, where are you spending Christmas? Thinking she'd fly home with her kids and be there like all of us had an opportunity to do. And she said, oh no, I'm staying here through Christmas Eve service and I'll fly out on Christmas Day. So when we put the word out that we wanted to collect enough money and love and energy and find a car for Wanda so that she could come back and forth, bring some of her family members down here, bring some of that good Southern cooking with her that she's known to do, you were also very, very generous. And so for Christmas, the Board of Trustees and the church and all of you were able to give Wanda Woman her car. So thank you. There's one thing I understand though is she has so much energy and love inside of her that since she's had the car, she hasn't put gasoline at all into the car. She gets in it and it just automatically goes.
Because she's Wonder Woman. That's the way it works. She just puts that golden lasso around. So here we are. We are all together. This morning when you got up, you made a divine appointment. It's no accident you're sitting where you are. It's no accident that you're right here as part of this First Unity community. Last week I challenged you to get out of a place of fear and step into and embrace the law of flow and circulation, the law of prosperity, the law of abundance. And you said, how? And I said, by tithing. And I gave you a quote by Charles Fillmore. He said that the moment, the exact moment, you begin to tithe 10% of what you receive, your faith is increased 100-fold. And then Edwin Gaines, I told you I've been listening to her. And she says, tithe where you are spiritually fed. So if you feel you are spiritually fed here, this is your place where you come for classes. It is proving that God is your source. And if you walk out of those doors hungry, not feeling fed, I can't imagine what you were doing. Because we got soul food. We've got that spiritual food and soul food, and it feels so good, doesn't it? And then we have our Club 104, which is an opportunity to join Club 104. We have some amazing vendors and businesses that have offered. Club 104 was brought about by Carol D'Alessandro, and then Reverend Richard stepped up to the plate and delivered it. Club 104 is meant to help First Unity with our everyday operating expenses. So if you feel
led to. We'd love to have you be a part of Club 104. There are an awful lot of benefits. They're in your program. So take a look at that and consider Club 104. But tithing is how you prove to yourself and the world that God is your source. It's how you step out boldly into the world, knowing that you have given, you have taken care of your spiritual, financial world, and the universe is taking care of you. You may not know how it's coming, but it's coming. And sometimes it's a surprise. Sometimes it's surprise abundance. And what wonderful blessings they are. We have different ways that you can give. As Reverend Temple said a couple weeks ago, when the plate goes by and somebody next to you doesn't put money in, don't make up a story in your head that they aren't giving. Because they might be giving online, or they might have pulled out their phone as soon as I started talking and started doing text to give. We make it easy so that it flows easy. So you can give online. You can text to give at 727-800-3493. And if you're online, joining us online via live stream, there's even a button for you to click on there. And we are happy that you are spiritually fed here. So if we'll all stand and say our abundance prayer together and just absorb that you were spiritually fed here today. The abundance of God is my infinite source. I now open my mind and my heart to give and receive all God's good, all God's prosperity, all God's abundance. As God is my source, all things are possible. And so it is. And I'll share with y'all, I was starting to get the flu. Paula's had it for like 10 days now. And she's trying to give it to me, and I'm fighting it. And then after first service, I was feeling pretty down, pretty low, because it was trying to overcome me. And one of our congregants came up to me, and she does essential oils at our Healthy Green Market. And she said, here, and she put a drop of peppermint, lavender, and lemongrass. And I feel energized. I am ready to go. So you got to get you some of that stuff if you don't have it.
There's a reason to rejoice, you see. Everybody come out, let's commence to singing joyfully.
Everybody look up and feel the hope that we've been waiting on. Everybody's glad, but it's not a fear, dread is known.
Freedom is here, it's got a heart singing so joyfully. Just look above, you owe it to yourself to check it out.
We always knew that you'd be free somehow.
In harmony, we'll show the world that we've got liberty. It's such a change for us to live so independently. Freedom is easy, and our hearts singing so joyfully. Just look around, you owe it to yourself to check it out. Can't you feel a brand new day? Can't you feel a brand new day? Can't you feel a brand new day?
Woo!
brand new year, a brand new decade. It is a brand new day. Wow. Reverend Dr. Temple Hayes is back on solid ground here in Florida. She's down in Fort Lauderdale today at the CSL with BB, and then they'll be making their way back home. We all hold space that they travel safely. She was on her Spirit at Sea cruise, and I've seen the pictures look fabulous. I can't wait to hear the stories, and she'll be back here next week so we can all give her a wonderful welcome home. Her products are right outside, her books and CDs on the left as you go out, and then on the right is the box office, and you're going to want to pay attention to that because y'all are going to flood it. By the time it's over, y'all gonna be fighting to get out there. Who's gonna get there first? Because we have a limited thing going on. But this Friday, we have Paul Wilburn and the Blue Roses coming. Paul is the theater director at St. Pete College, and he also runs the Palladium. He's written a book called Cigar City, Tales from a 1980s Creative Ghetto. Evidently, back in the day, Tampa was called Cigar City. And he's going to have his band here. He's going to be telling stories and singing songs. It's an intimate evening of song and stories. So the tickets are available at the box office. Then next Friday, we have our oneness service. On the subject of oneness, and the subject this time is gratitude. So the entire ministerial team, the dance ministry, and the music ministry will be right up here sharing with you on the subject of oneness and gratitude. Next Friday night. And then on January 31st, that's three Fridays in a row, Wanda Nero Butler has put together another Presence production, Music Meditation Ministry and the Miracle in You. And she asks that you bring a bottle of water to be blessed to that service. And those services are both free, and you can come, and it's going to be an amazing opportunity to just experience all that we have to offer here at First Unity. Today, this afternoon, in Lagatuda Hall after lunch, Reverend Ron and Maria are going to be doing Create Your Vision Board. It's going to be great. You're going to get to start on your vision board for 2020. What are you visioning? And then on Tuesday night, Reverend Maria is teaching the energy of it all. And she describes in the video that the energy of it all is you. So that's going to be a 6 weeks course that starts this Tuesday. You can sign up online or you can sign up right out at the box office. On Tuesday, we also have Chakra for Beginners. I had a couple of people come up to me and say, I'm embarrassed to say, and I've heard of it a lot, but I don't really know what a chakra is. And in that same week, I had two different people come up in different ways and say the same thing. And I said, well, we're going to do a Chakra for Beginners class. And so that's what we're doing on Tuesday. And then we have so many wonderful classes coming up. They're all in your program. You can take a look in the program. And Zumba, how we got started today, starts this Wednesday. We'll be in Lagatuda Hall right after the Wednesday meditation service. So come in here and get all calm and meditative, and then you're going to go out to Zumba before you go home, and then I promise you'll sleep well. You will. Oh, because your mind will be still, but your body will be exercised. So you can come for yoga on Mondays, or you can come for Zumba on Wednesdays. But here at First Unity Community, we are helping you keep those New Year's resolutions to be healthy in your body, your spirit, and your mind. So take a look at all we have coming up. This is a wonderful class we're doing on Thursdays, and it's so much fun with the work of Deepak Chopra. So come and join us. Even if you didn't come last week, you're welcome to come for week two and three. You don't have to have been present for the other one to enjoy them all. So we also have something else coming up. If you're a sports fan, you know the Super Bowl happens the first Sunday in February. And the man is here to tell you about Super Sunday here at First Unity.
You know, we meditate real well. We Zumba real well. And we party better than anybody else, isn't that right? Mm-hmm. Especially on Super Bowl Sunday. Now, come on, we've had 70-plus people on these parties, and it's like, this is like our ninth annual Super Bowl party. So tickets can be sold.
It's my second one. Tickets are being sold at the box office this year. So there's only 100 tickets. Quite a few got gone this morning. Mm-hmm. So there's only 100 chances. So you'll buy your ticket at the box office.
Right,
then we'll give it to you. You will take it to the man. In Lagatuda Hall, and he'll put you up on the board where you want to be. Alan will take care of placing you on the board where you want to be for your chances to win.
That's right. A flat screen, 4K smart, 55-inch color TV. That's for the winner at the end of the game. Now, first, second, and third quarters, you can win $100. And if you had the same score for the first three quarters, you win $300. You see how that works? Anyway, I'll explain how the raffle, we have to call it, how the raffle is played. We're also looking for chili cookers.
Yes.
Now, I don't know about
chili
you,
cook-off.
But last year we had like 15 buckets of chili, and it was the most incredible dinner. So yes. Sign up for that. Make sure you come. Doesn't cost anything. It's a BYOB evening, so whatever you want to do.
And I'm throwing down the gauntlet. Last year, Juan De Niro Butler won that chili cook-off.
Uh-huh.
We do a meat and a vegetarian, and I'm throwing down the thing saying I'm going to bring in some southern chili, too. So we're going to. So if you want to get
now
in on
better
that,
than that,
cooking chili, because I know we have some wonderful cooks in our community, chili and cornbread. See, that's the secret. Wanda made cornbread to go along with her chili. She didn't just stick to the chili. She brought in that side of cornbread. So
what can I say? She's from Atlanta.
That's a secret.
I know. But watch her, okay? So we hope to see you all there. It's the best football party in town. And come on back and see me.
And the best chili party. So if you don't care about the football.
Yeah.
And somebody told me Tennessee Titans are doing pretty well. But I had no idea. Yeah. But I'm going to be there for the chili for sure.
Uh-huh. Sure. Okay. Thank you.
All right. Let's come on up for the peace song. Come on. Come on. Protects us. I am the power. The presence of God watches over us. I am the presence. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. For God is amazing.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is amazing.
God bless you.
And remember this one thing as you go in this week. God loves you just the way you are.
Yes. Yeah.